get along and technology, because this all technology that I'm talking is basically what has been registered over time for many years, especially in ASHRAE in the United States. ASHRAE in the US having a technical committee specific for indoor air quality, and they are talking about different type of technology and how to actually improve the air quality by using a simpler or but better means. So the earlier presentation indicates the type of technology that can you have in advanced air filtration systems. And actually, when you have the technology, you need the product to actually do it, you know. So in the ASHRAE, if you go to ASHRAE Expo every January, you'll find the meetings that we discuss thoroughly technology about that. Then you go to the expo to get one or two of the products, you know, to really do the job. So I have actually talked to GF about this thing, and one of the things that I'm very amazed about them is that the studies being done. All the studies being done by the independent third-party laboratory says that H1N1 flu, if you put this thing, you have the inactivation rate of 99 plus percent with over time. For SARS virus, you have this inactivation rate of 99% plus over time, certain period of time. Yeah. This is another type of virus, novel virus. I don't know what this, but maybe they have problem with that. So this is the time that taken and is really being inactivated. This is another type of methicillin resistance of some kind of mold. Okay? Yeah, you have a lot of problems with mold inside the buildings. You have this inactivation period of around near to 2 days over there, and with the inactivation rate of 97 plus percent with the installation of this product. And this is the technology basis approval. And basically, the installation will be based on the CFM, the calculation of the CFM. You have the CFM of these different sizes. Yeah. So basically, you air handlers, you will have your CFMs. So it's quite easy to size based on your number, your CFMs. So this unit will having this around 500 to 2000 CFM. This is actually a mini unit, designed for a small enclosed area. And you have this, it's not really that clear, mine is clear. It has this, you know, for example, a room, you put inside one room, a room. It's basically just like something like, what is it called? Something like that, a portable unit installed at the room.
Air purifier.
Yeah, specifically for that room. Even they do handles ice makers, and this is actually a commercial air purifier. I'm not so sure, but this is something like the one that they're working with Shaklee. The unit they make for Shaklee, the whole unit combined with the other filters, and also to track whatever particle there. So for Remy, this is the CFMs. All the product have comes not with 1 year warranty, all the product comes with 2 years warranty. And cells is replaced fluoroplastic sleeve on the unit, means no dusting. Yeah. And the applications is actually an example of successful application you can have in, say, schools. Yeah. The results show that with the Guardian air units installed, the absenteeism fell by 15 to 20%. They have actually improved this having these savings. And this is other application that is possible to be used at many locations, like hotels, hospitals, office buildings, doctor office, jails over here. I'm not sure whether we need to put a better environment in jails, you know. over here, I'm not sure. Condominium, basement, shops, singles, family homes. Thank you. This is, I'm going a bit fast over here because the second one is going to take more time. Yeah? But I feel that it's quite straightforward, this thing. The technology, you can ask more questions to me. But I have quoted to one of these projects. I heard last time JKL was doing some, I think PMO last time for greening. Then I think the project doesn't take off. I think somebody asked for something like that. They were asking about three times to confirm my our pricing, which they said is a bit like on the low side. On the low side. So it doesn't take much to do these things, and because if you compare with some other technology, it requires bulky instruments, yeah, more bulky equipment, more materials, and it doesn't. But it's not really the maybe as effective. But you have to get to know more about how is it work. But the most important thing is that you can browse through the website that it really works by the third party verification and lab studies. I think that's the only way to tell whether it's study or not, is actually working or not. So all the studies done by, like for example, Kansas universities and all those places. That is actually one of the situation. And the reliability of the system has been taken care on by the lab testing. Yeah, so it's done on that technology. Number two is that how workable the system. That's why we have made some comparison over UV lights over there. And if you also can go through our catalog over here, and you can get more information from the website. Basically, we are also telling you that you have to be very careful with a simple UV light system. It does work. Yeah, it does work. But it's a light. We have a straight light. Yeah? Light, it doesn't maneuver. Yeah? It goes straight. So at the place, the area that the beam reach, yeah, and the dosage is enough, they will definitely actually don't have any problem with the mold growth or bacteria growth. But the air is traveling. The air is traveling. I got information like, for example, people would like to put the UV or some of other things just simply from the air duct systems. Yeah. Have they consulted the designer? Have they consulted? Yeah? What is the speed of the air going through? Because of the dosage will involve the exposure time. The intensity of the unit times the exposure time then is equivalent to the right dosage. If it is too fast, then you will not have the effectiveness. I already gone into a presentation done by a Pentagon lady professor, I think, because they did make a lot of studies on this thing because of the possibility of attack on America. So they have both knowledge and studies done over the matter. And from the presentation, I can see clearly that bacteria, all these molds come in various design, various. Some with shields, cengkeram, dia ada cengkeram, dia ada cover dia. So dia macam dengan manusia juga kan. Ada yang lebih kuat daripada yang lain kan. Ada yang lebih hidup lagi lama, ada yang 40 lebih dah lahir dah kan. Ada yang mantap lagi 80-90. So that is the kind of thing with all these things. So with yang kuat sikit tu kadang dia require, kalau nak bunuh dia tu teruk sikit lah kan. So that is actually the that we have. So tu saya nak cakap bahasa Inggeris, cakap Melayu dia jadi cakap kampung. So that is the thing lah. Basically, when we come to that situation, we have actually to decide the right type of units to be used. Yeah? Then you have to understand that it doesn't, the technology is wise, it's okay, but the application wise. Most of the time, if you use UV or something like that, you have actually to have to enlarge the duct size. Yeah? Because why? When you enlarge the duct size, you actually slow down the air. So you create more retention time for the air to be exposed to the will be like. So, but still you have to calculate that. But I have seldom see this installation applications. And require all engineers to really take a look on that. This actually create the positive negative ionization of the particulates. Yeah? So bila particulates ni kalau dia ada ions, dia orang kata dicaskan, dia akan melekat antara satu sama lain. So when you have you over time you continuously created this this charge to particulates, they're getting bigger. When it's getting bigger, it's going to you have your normal air filtration is going to start there. As simple as that. So that is called advanced air filtration system. We are not going to put any filter over there. We are going to encourage the formation of bigger particles so that you can attract them as at your normal filter. So that is how a complete filtration is done by using this technology. Anybody have any questions, doubts, whatsoever?
Kalau nak pasang selepas apa tu ya, selepas coil. Dia tak perlukan apa-apa complicated pemasangan kan, just plug in je kan.
It's a like very simple installation. Because okay, macam dia orang pasang dekat for cooling coil, for sure about that. Because what that we want is actually a good air quality in the room, right? From the studies done, that it doesn't mean anything about the thing. It's okay. Maybe UV light works that way better. But on our side, it's okay to install right after that. You know, I show you the installation. And it works well.